Apple has a long-standing history of introducing innovative and often revolutionary products. Starting from the early Macintosh to the game-changing iPod and iPhones we see today, Apple's developed a reputation of staying ahead of its competition. But it seems that ever since Steve Jobs passed away, the creative genius of Apple is losing its spark. Over the years, Apple has upgraded its flagship iPhone and MacBooks, but we haven't really seen truly revolutionary products since the iPhone. Yes, the AirPods and Apple Smartwatch can be seen as innovative products, but they're hardly game changers. Perhaps it's too much to ask for. After all, creating a completely new product isn't easy. Which is maybe why Apple has decided to work on improving existing technology. Tim Cook has talked about a lot of different technologies since he became the CEO, but one technology that he's absolutely fixated on is virtual and augmented reality. The Apple VR headset has been in the making for quite a long time now. Design and approval delays have caused Apple to lose out on the VR headset market to competitors like Facebook Oculus, which is currently the dominant market leader, followed by Sony and HTC. So what exactly is Apple up to with their VR headset? Surely, Apple could have released a VR headset a long time ago to establish a foothold in the headset market. Yes, they could have, but this is Apple we're talking about. Apple has a very distinct policy when it comes to developing and launching products. With Apple, everything about their products has to be exactly right, from design and functionality to the aesthetics. So we can already guess the reason why Apple's taking so long to roll out their VR headset is probably because they don't want their VR headset to look anything like the ones that are currently in the market. Knowing Apple, we can expect the VR headset to be power-packed with functionality. But the more Apple delays, the more features it will have to accommodate into the headset because Facebook is already researching the next-gen VR and AR headsets as well. According to Bloomberg, Apple is developing a very niche headset that's going to cost an arm and a leg. The current VR headsets start from $300 and go up to $1,000 per unit. The Apple VR is expected to cost much more than that. This means that the Apple VR headset may be specifically targeted at creators or gamers. Otherwise, the high cost won't be justifiable. Why would anyone go for, say, a $3,000 Apple VR headset when they can get the Facebook Oculus for a much lower price? The VR headset that Apple is currently developing is said to be a stepping stone for the augmented reality glasses that Apple is also currently working on. From this information, we can understand that Apple is going for the staggered approach that they had with the iPhone. The iPod was first released as a music player. It was then upgraded to the iPod Touch that could play music, videos, and had access to the internet. The iPod Touch was then upgraded to the iPhone. The VR headset seems like the first iteration, which will eventually be upgraded into game-changing AR glasses. Details about the VR headset that Apple is developing are still sketchy due to secrecy around the project. However, according to Bloomberg and other publications, some specifications have surfaced thanks to unnamed insiders. The VR headset is codenamed N301, whereas the AR glasses are codenamed N421. The VR headset's in its prototype phase, which means that it can either be given the green light for production or scrapped entirely to begin from scratch. The AR glasses, on the other hand, are in their early design stage. The AR glasses need a lot of research and development right now. Although Apple has included AR features in iPhone since 2017, migrating those features into fully functional AR glasses is going to be a difficult task. The current AR glasses in the market can also be considered as beta versions at best. The AR glasses are still in their nascent stage. The possible launch date for the VR headset is around 2022, whereas there's no tentative date for the AR glasses. Safe to say that the launch date of the AR glasses, at this point, entirely depends on the success of the VR headset. At this point, it's not entirely clear whether the VR headset is going to be tethered or wireless. HTC and Sony headsets are tethered, whereas the Facebook Oculus is wireless. Both have their own merits. The tethered headsets are connected to a computer or a console. This allows the headset to use the computing power of the system it's connected to. Tethered headsets, therefore, usually have the advantage of having better processing power. This also allows their design to be lighter as compared to wireless headsets. Oculus, on the other hand, which is a completely wireless headset, allows users the ability to enjoy freedom of movement. This freedom, however, comes at the cost of reduced processing power. Considering the emphasis that Apple puts on the design and aesthetics, it would be a good guess to say that the Apple VR glasses are going to be wireless. Tethered glasses just don't work with Apple's design aesthetics. According to Inside Reports, Apple initially designed the VR headset to have a high-powered processing chip with a cooling fan. This design was scrapped as it made the headset clunky and added extra weight that could have created neck strain issues for the users. Apple's trying out different chips that can deliver a power-packed performance. If rumors are to be believed, the chip that the VR headset will have is going to be even more powerful than the M1 processor used in the 2020 release of the MacBook. The VR headset is most likely going to be a standalone device, but if we assume that it will be powered with the iPhone, then it can possibly have a host of AR and VR features that are already loaded in the iPhone. Qualcomm is already working on phone-powered AR and VR headsets. The benefit of phone-powered headsets is that they're less clunky and use the chipset of the phone for most of the heavy lifting. However, considering the time that Apple's taken to develop its VR headset, it's not likely to be phone-powered. Apple seems to be aiming for a completely immersive, standalone VR headset experience. The initial version of the VR headset had space for users who needed eyeglasses. The revamped design ended up eliminating the extra space to make the headset fit closer to the face and become more compact. The headset is now said to have a system where users with poor eyesight can insert prescription contact lenses. This creates a problem. Apple will have to comply with prescription regulations in all countries where the VR headset will be sold. Another obstacle will be, how will Apple sell the prescription lenses? The exterior of the VR headset is said to be made from a sort of fabric that will make the headset ergonomic. If, and most likely, the headset's going to be wireless, then we should expect a battery source somewhere around the backside of the headband of the VR headset. Spatial audio is another feature that may be present in the headset. It's also possible that Apple may decide to integrate the AirPods with the headset. Apple's also testing the prototype with external cameras to integrate some augmented reality features into the headset. The cameras will be used for hand tracking and spatial awareness. If the cameras are included in the final version, then we can expect the headset to include air typing. The headset will support full 8K resolution, which will allow users to focus even on small typeface fonts and other minute details. The cameras, in particular, can be used to track hand movements for input. This would greatly differentiate the Apple VR headset from the other headsets in the market that use game controller-like peripherals. Alternatively, there are also rumors that the headset can come with wearable finger bands that can be tracked for controlling input. As far as the hardware and functionality is concerned, Apple seems to have left no stone unturned. Over the last few years, we've seen Apple acquire some promising 3D gaming, VR, and AR startups, including NextVR, that specializes in streaming media content in VR, and Aconia Holographics, which is an AR headset lens maker. Apple has also hired the services of some of the leading experts who worked on the Oculus, HoloLens, and 3D experts from Hollywood. Apple is also working with Qualcomm for future iPhones. Can this partnership in some way also be used for the headset? If the VR headsets come equipped with 5G functionality, it can set them apart from their competitors. It will allow the VR and AR glasses to stand on their own and carry out advanced processing through the 5G network. Due to the secrecy surrounding the development of the headset, it's very difficult to accurately pin down how the final version will look. What's been discussed so far in the last few minutes has been based on what experts who have been following Apple think the headset should look like. The 2022 release date feels like it may be pushed back because Apple has a tradition of announcing new products before they're launched. This is done to give developers time to create applications. So far, Apple has not formally announced any VR headsets, and there are no formal guidelines on how app developers can make their apps compatible. The staggered approach also means that the initial version of the headset may be exclusively for creators, followed by later priced-down versions for general users. Whatever the case may be, it remains to be seen. What do you think of Apple's VR glasses? Do you think they can compete with the big brands already dominating the market? Let us know what you think in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release a new video. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.